right, Michael, thank you. Well, since it is weather dependent, I guess we better just check in with our own resident weather expert, Ethan Rosuck, here in for Tyler for us tonight. We've been talking about this Northern Lights. I mean, that's all everybody's talking about. Everyone's really interested in it. We've seen the pictures all day from last night. So if people go out after the show, of course, what are they going to be able to see out
there? We've already gotten some pictures already, actually, that I'll show you in just a second here. You know, everything is just getting started as this very historic geomagnetic storm continues. A couple days ago, we had a level G4, a severe watch issued for this geomagnetic storm. That was the first time since 2005 where such a watch was issued. But then yesterday, we made it to G5 level, which is extreme, and it's the first G5 warning issued by the Space Weather Prediction Center in more than 20 years. And that's the story for the entire country. That's the story again for tonight as well. So after the newscast, go outside, go away from city lights, and go low on the horizon and look north. That's the best way you'll get to see the Northern Lights. And from now till about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and because of how strong this geomagnetic storm is, it could bring some impacts to radio and satellite frequencies, but those have been few and far between. This is what I'm thinking here. Basically, the further north you go, basically once you get to Kokomo, Lafayette, Peru, into northern Indiana, better chance you could see the Northern Lights with the naked eye. Around Indianapolis and most of our viewing area, you could see it, maybe not as profound, but even better with a camera. And you could do the long exposure in night mode on your iPhone, and I know for a fact that Android does have a similar mode. And as always, send us your pictures, because this is a very historic event going from top to bottom, from all the way up into well northern Canada, into the North Pole, and then down into the southern portions of the United States. Yesterday, saw pictures in Florida and in Southern California. Here are some pictures we've already gotten from Lori over in Noblesville. This was taken a little bit after 10:15. This is really cool and kind of beaming of the light here again. And this is going to get more profound into the night. And then this is Lance over in North Salem, so well west of here. And nonetheless, just depends if you are in the right place at the right time. Less in the way of cloud cover tonight, too. We'll have moonlit skies, even better cloud cover than when we had last night. And this is going to come on the heels of a very nice day. 31st day with a high of 70 or greater since January 1st. Second most to date on record, tying 2007. So the most in 17 years. 72 was our high today. Mother's Day looking great. Mid to upper 70s for a high temperature tomorrow. Same story on Monday. And actually, our temperatures are going to be pretty consistent for the week here. Not going to be dropping too much. In fact, we're going to slowly but surely get mild again by the time we get to the middle to late portion of next week. That is when I'm thinking highs near 80 will return. 77 tomorrow for Mother's Day. Best rain chances for the week are going to be late Monday and throughout the daytime on Tuesday. Stray shower possible Wednesday, late Thursday, and then there's that high of 80 once again by this point next week. Alexa.